Yo, yo, what's the deal? It's your boy Bruce Wayne, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Bruce Wayne Live. Hopefully everyone is good out there. You know I'm usually here on a Sunday, but it's a Monday. Happy Monday. 2 weeks. 2 weeks, niggas. 2 weeks without the Batman. I hope y'all was able to handle it. 2 weeks without the kid. We had the Super Bowl. We had the Super Bowl, which turned out to be a blowout. That was a blowout affair. And then we just had Valentine's Day, man. Shouts out to all my lovers out there, all my Valentine people. You know what I mean? Everybody snuggling and all that. Even those that's just doing winter love. Because you know once the summer hit and the heat get here, shit is on. COVID's over. Once COVID subsides and the summer get here, it is on. So enjoy the winter snuggling and all that. Hopefully all of y'all out there staying COVID-free and enjoyed your Valentine's Day. I know damn well I did. Shouts out to everybody that watches the show and tunes in. Y'all know how I do. Y'all know how I get down. But for those of y'all that's your first time watching the show, you already know what it is, man. I need y'all to head over to Hip Hop Heads Worldwide, the most popping group on Facebook. There it is right there. And make sure you join the group. If you're an artist, you can submit your music. You know, if you're just a fan of hip-hop music, that's it right there, man. Once you see that logo, you know you're there. You know you have arrived. As I was saying, if you're a fan of hip-hop, you could just feel free to join along in a dialogue or submit. Just try to keep it respectful. If you're an artist, submit your music. But we do have the disclaimer. If your music is trash, we're not putting it up, niggas. I'm sorry. And don't be inboxing me, because dudes stay inboxing me. You know what? Bruce Water ain't going. Listen, man. It's other moderators in the group. I may shout it down, whatever. Or someone else may shout it down. But just keep on submitting. Disclaimer. This is a hip-hop group, man. So if you're trying to put trap, mumble, and all this other stuff, or that's probably 100% the reason, y'all. You got 1,000 other groups on Facebook that will accommodate that. We are dealing with hip-hop. Once in a while, something slipped through the cracks. Once in a while, something does manage to slip through the cracks. Also, make sure you shoot up to YouTube and follow the kid. Subscribe, Wayne NT, man. Shoot over there and follow the kid. Like, share, and comment. Like, share, and comment on this show as well. It is greatly appreciated. It is greatly appreciated, man. A lot going on, man. A lot going on. It's been 2 weeks. I'm not going to try to recap 2 weeks, niggas. It is what it is. Those 2 weeks I was off and enjoying the Super Bowl and doing Lover's Lane and all that. Nah, man. We starting them 2 weeks. It is what it is. You lived through it. Hopefully you remember it. But I'm honored too, man. This night, you know, got a special guest. Did I have an opportunity to do a special guest with a hip-hop legend? Bang, there it is, man. Shouts out. Shouts out to Rampage, man, the last Boy Scout. First lieutenant of the hip-hop, of the Flipmo squad. Yes, he is. For those of y'all that may not know who he is, bang, there goes another picture of him. There's a picture of him with Busta Rhymes, Spliff Star. Unfortunately, Rod Digger's not in that picture, man, but she's still a part of the squad, man. That's the picture we had, niggas. It is what it is. That's what we got up. But, yeah, man, he was responsible for Wild for the Night. Also dropped the Monster Classic verse on the remix, the Flavor in Your Air remix. And, you know, I had a chance to chop it up with him, and I'm going to get into some of that interview. I'm going to get into some of that interview, man. But you already know how I do, man. I got to make sure everybody knows that I'm on. I got to make sure that everybody knows the Batman is on. So I'm going to start this off with a video, and then we're going to come back. Hold tight. Don't go nowhere. I just got to make sure people are aware that the Batman is in the building. Matter of fact, I'm going to give y'all one of my classics, man. Y'all getting Bruce Wayne tonight, man. Y'all getting the Batman tonight. Hey, yo, this is Beast Aside, Bruce Wayne featuring Sean Price. Let's go.
Yeah. Yeah, let's go. Ah. Beast Aside. I got a beast inside. No Loch Ness, no Sasquatch, no Mr. Hyde. Yeah, a Podger nigga that'll gladly take your muffin off. Stand over you until your ass walk that off. I try to keep him restrained and watch my temperature. But he be wanting blood like Transylvania. He gets to go and ain't no talking it out. Shit, combat, chest puffed out. Beast no round. Tear your head off, spit down your neck and rip your heart out. And though I may have turned to Mr. Wayne, the Podger nigga side of me will always stay the same. I tell him, chill, relax, we out them buildings. Fuck these clown niggas, let's focus on the millions. But he don't answer, no reply, nope. And we before, it's just a matter of time before he blow like a motherfucking landmine. I got a beast inside, light her up, light her up. I got a beast inside, light her up, light her up. I got a beast inside, light her up, light her up. I got a beast inside. Let it rub my head, man. Like rough. Back off you. Real recognize real, that's no bull. But at the same time, wolf recognize wolf. I play civil, but be wantin' to howl. Show my fangs, let it bang, lay your motherfucker down. When I was young, green light, no stopping. But now I'm older, so I gotta weigh my options. But these haters would love to see me boxing. They do fugazi shit, then they call the cops in. And yo, the jail cell is just like a coffin. I body them, then the system body him. God help me ignore these clowns. I'm just trying to get rich and hold the whole family down. Life's a bitch, but I still pulled the panties down. And fucked her hard till she said cha-ching. My niggas do not want to see my inner Stephen King. Nope, I got a beast inside. I got a beast inside. Like rough. Trying to hold the name. I got a beast inside. Like rough. It's growing. Like rough. It's growing. I got a beast inside. Like rough.
Hold me back.
Like rough.
Hold me back.
Half man, half animal, manimal. Jekyll and Hyde, nigga, the beast on my side, P. The beast inside, about to come out in two beats of beeps and slide. My hand's a weapon of mass destruction. Your family's peasants get slapped for nothing. I don't fight fear, I'm right here. Footing your ass so far that I got shit on my night ears. New Year, gun in the air, popper. I share not a son of a sharecropper. Tons of guns, I get them for free. Pop your hun, that's under the sycamore tree. Blast the bastard, Duke, I'm extra. Then wrapped in plastic, Duke, I'm Dexter. Rap nigga that the game despise. P, Wayne Enterprise, nigga.
I got a beast inside, light her up.
Turn the lights down.
Light her up. Yeah, I got
on.
A beast inside, light her up. Light her up.
Let's go.
I got a beast inside, like rough.
Gonna tolerate
like
that
rough.
Shit.
I got a beast inside, like rough. Like
before you let them niggas know.
He gets graphic like a Hollywood action thriller. No special effects, just a cloak and dagger. He from the projects where they creep up like the boogeyman. Or pull them things, I'd advise you the boogeyman.
Hits
can cheap, they do you for about half a grand. Or even cheaper, and do that shit effortless. Fuck a Red Bull when you like a Pegasus. What's the point of the song, what's the emphasis? For them niggas that be soft like peaches. Please do not take my jewel dropping for weakness. Cause at the same time I'm hollering black power. Will be the same time I'm giving you a lead shower. Every day I be trying to be a good nigga and suppress my wild out raging hood nigga. So I advise you to let me be. Cause King Kong ain't got shit on me.
Real.
I got a beast inside, like rough.
You know what I mean?
Like rough.
I know what it is.
I got a beast inside, like rough.
I'm going before a nigga
like
push back.
King Kong, I got a beast
got
inside,
shit
like
on
rough.
Me.
Like
rough. What's going on?
I got a beast inside, like
when
rough.
Roll out, he's
like rough. Trying to hold your head. Trying to hold your head, try not to blow, but these niggas is testing you. The whole fucking world is testing you. Fucking system's testing you. How long can a nigga hold that fucking steaming? How long can a nigga hold that fucking steaming?
Push back, niggas.
Dark Knight album, man. Dead Earth stood still. Let's bounce. Right there. For all my niggas that be stalking them streets. You know what I mean? All them beast niggas. Niggas that be trying to.
Yeah, yeah, I'm back. That was Beast Inside, man. Bruce Wayne featuring Sean Price, man. One of my classics under my belt. But like I said, man, I had a great opportunity to speak to the last Boy Scout Rampage. We're going to jump into that, but I'm going to jump to some news real quick. Because y'all know, before the when the election was happening, I was keeping everybody abreast, and I was throwing out all men and all hands on deck to make sure we get this fellow out the White House. And yo, man, he was being brought up on all type of charges, and he beat it. He beat it, man. It was kind of pretty much a no-brainer he was going to beat it, because Republicans are still so fucking scared of him that, you know, Democrats didn't have enough members in the Senate or the House to get a conviction. So Donald Trump, man, he beats it again. Second, you know, impeachment, and he beats it again. Republicans unwilling to convict, even though they basically know he incited the riot, the insurrection. Mitch McConnell came out and basically said that he did it after everything was said and done. But it seems like it appears Trump still has a serious hold on the Republican, you know, base, on the Republican Party. Also, as far as Twitter, man, Twitter also reported that Trump is still banned. They said he is permanently banned. No matter what, he is banned, niggas. So you don't got to worry about the Trumpster jumping back online with that microphone, with that megaphone, and causing mayhem. You do not have to worry about that. Also, I'm going to touch this real quick, because this is wild. Especially, let this make sure your kids is aware of this. This is trending for some reason, so I touched it. Some chick put Gorilla Glue in her hair, played herself, went viral. Went viral with the Gorilla Glue in her hair. Even Beyonce, and I believe Chance the Rapper stepped in. She had a video crying and wailing. Talking about she didn't know it was that serious. She put the Gorilla Glue in her head. And had the nerve to say she was probably thinking about suing the company. Which she'd have probably got laughed out of court. But she wound up getting surgery. People jumped in. She wound up getting surgery. I ain't going to play the video of her boohooing. But yeah, man, she's all right now, man. She got her shit back together. She's all right. And what really kills me about this story is you have a nincompoop that followed right behind her trying to prove that her story was fake. This fella right here. I got him with the shades on, though. I should have had a picture without the shades on so we could see the nincompoop up close. But yeah, he's a rapper. I believe he might be from Louisiana. I don't know exactly where he's from. Len Martin, something like that. But this fool wanted to show that it wasn't that serious. He wanted to show it wasn't that serious, so this guy went and glued a cup to his lips. That's what he decided to do. He decided to do to glue a cup to his lips. Check this out.
That shit ain't true. I'm going to show y'all something. I got some Gorilla Glue right here. Super Glue real. Why something? I'm going to take it, put it on this cup, put it in my mouth. Then I'm going to be able to lick it and get it off. It's easy. Gorilla Glue garbage. I'm telling you now. We need to clear the air because you don't want something crazy happening. Put it on you.
Farewell thing. You know what? I think. Hey. You
don't put it on my mouth.
Yeah, so Einstein over here decided to glue a cup to his lips. And this is basically what happened. My man sitting there looking like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Looking like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Moose. Looking like a complete idiot. Looking like a circus clown. Yo. And the thing is, people say he may have did that to go viral. And the crazy thing is, he caught a couple of interviews. But if you're a parent and you have small children at home, make sure you let them know this is not the way to go, niggas. This is not the way to go. This is a cautionary tale. But once again, man, had a chance to chop it up at Rampage, Flipmo Squad in the building. And we spoke about a lot. And one of the things I spoke about was basically, you know, him, his influence and what got him into hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Check it out. Let's get it, man. It's your boy, Bruce Wayne, sitting here with the Flipmo legend. Rampage, First Lieutenant, you know what I mean? I said, fella yard man, fella yardy.
Yeah, big up to all the yard man, them. That's
definitely, man, definitely. But yeah, yes. Let's get into it. As far as the Rampage name and the Last Boy Scout, let them know what's the origin behind that, how that come about. What's the
Rampage
meaning?
Is a rugged MC from Brooklyn, you know, Rude Boy. I'm a rugged MC. I got rugged bars. That's me. That's why they call me Rampage. My shit is rude. It's relentless. Bars on top of bars for whoever won it. You dig?
Me dig. But tell, what's the Last Boy Scout thing about?
Yeah, because I'm the last one of my crew. I got to save the best for last.
Okay. Yeah, okay. I like that. I like that whole premise and everything behind that. As far as the music thing, man, what influenced you, man? As far as, you know, wanting to become a part of this hip-hop culture, any specific
artists? What influenced me is, you know, my West Indian roots, my American roots, growing up in Flatbush, listening to all them, Yard Man them, the Ninja Mans.
Yeah, man.
The Super Cats, the Bad Boy Buju Bantans, the Chub Rocks, the Special Leds, the X Clans, the UTFOs, the Howie T's, you know what I'm saying? These are the people that was in my area in Flatbush, Tilden Barroom, the Skating Ring on Utica.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, all them things inspire me, you know, and then being outside doing the bad things, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah, we don't gotta, you know, we all know.
I gotta keep it 100.
Yeah, you gotta keep 100. That's the way it is. But I'm just saying, you know, you don't have
I'm from Flatbush.
You don't have to expand.
Anybody know any kid from Flatbush? They know, you know, a lot of kids was up to no good. I was, you know, one of them kids that move around into the studio, into getting to the money, getting to the bag, getting to the rims, getting to the cars, whatever I needed.
I already know.
Big up to all the Flatbush Pulley kids and all them boys, is, you know, getting to that. You know
we already know, but we ain't letting nobody implicate themselves for no BS on this.
No.
So you don't have to go too deep. You know what I'm saying?
This them young boy thing, you know.
Yeah,
as a young boy, you know.
Yeah, but as far as gripping that mic and grabbing that mic, was that your first venture into hip hop, or was it a b-boy thing, a culture thing, a DJ thing? Was there anything before Rampage the MC, or was it just
DJ.
I'm grabbing the mic, you know what I'm saying?
So first time I started the game, my mother bought me 2 turntables and a mixer.
Mm.
Gemini, 2 turntables and a mixer. She invested in me, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, when I was young, I always wanted to be a DJ before an artist. But then, you know, being around my cousin since the 80s, he definitely influenced me, which is Busta. It's my first cousin.
Mm-hmm.
Being on the block, we both from Flatbush as well. Being on the block, playing Skelly, riding bikes,
playing
the early 80s.
You know, so the young people don't know what Skelly is, man. Break that down for them real quick.
Skelly's a game. Yeah, you take a top, you put plastic into it.
Clear to
boxes. You have to shoot the top into the boxes. Yeah. You have to take a candle and melt it in the boxes.
Yeah. Skelly definitely, you know, old school New York street game. Okay, so basically you said Bus influenced you, or Bus was all, you was around Busta.
Yeah, because he was rapping early, you know what I'm saying? Plus, he was learning his mathematics at the same time, you know what I'm saying? His degrees and stuff like that. So, you know, I was there on the block listening to all of that. And then, you know, everything stayed with me. You know, my pops influenced me. My pops is a guitarist, so my pops named Woofy. So, so Big Woofy, which is my pops, who, you know, influenced me a lot with the music, because him playing guitar and bass. So watching him growing up, having turntables, moms and believing me in school, 181, Walt Whitman, freestyling and lunch, banging on the tables, all them things was a part of the history in Old Boy. Okay,
that's what's up, man. As far as, you know, becoming a professional, entering the music on a professional level.
That was 92.
That was 92. But was that, you would, was what preceded Wild for the Night? because I know you had a history before that.
Before that, I dropped a joint called Beware the Ramsack.
That's what I'm saying.
Hit, Lyricist Lounge.
Lyricist Lounge. Underground
Flow. I'm first bussing. I'm bussing on Leaders of the New School album all together. A song called Spontaneous. That's the first record I ever been on. Was Leaders of the New School. Second album, song called Spontaneous. Yeah, plus, man. Before that, I was on the road with Leaders of the New School, opening up for Leaders of the New School.
How was that experience, man?
Oh, no, it was good. Traveling all the world, get to see everything. First time you see groupies, first time you see everything. You know what I'm saying? Traveling from state to state, I couldn't be no more than 17.
Yeah.
Then I finished school, better yet, I took my GED and got out because music I wanted to take on full time. Yeah. So 92, I get my first deal with Rowdy Records, with Arista, Rowdy Records, and Flip Mode. The first artist assigned to Flip Mode.
That's what's up. Yeah, chopping it up with my man, Rampage, the Last Boy Scout, chopping up about a few things there. Jumping to a couple more things in the news, man. Casanova, as you know, he's been in some hot water. He's basically been, he's in jail right now. Waiting the charges he's facing as far as the racketeering charges. You think he'd be taking it easy, sitting down, chilling or whatever? That is not the case. That is not the case. Casanova is not taking it easy. A video came out with this man doing some shit called the June Bug Challenge. Shit is wild, man. The June Bug Challenge. Check this out. Tugging in my Reebok, riding with a T-shirt. I heard he shot. Chuckle make a big bucks. He made a shot. Yo, what the fuck is up with that? Yo, this man is doing the June Bug Challenge. The video got out, as you can see, leaked through the public. I don't understand if he just was bored. He's filled with boredom, trying to get his mind off the scenario. But that shit is wild to me right there that he would even indulge in that, because you know that's going to get out there. I don't know if he wanted some attention. He wanted to let people know, yo, I'm still here. I'm incarcerated, but I'm still here. And I'm doing this June Bug Challenge. But he's up in Westchester County Jail for facing his alleged racketeering case. His video visitation privileges has been pulled. And he also received another charge for having no mask. So, was it worth it, nigga? Was it worth it? Also, man, Kevin Hart, another cautionary tale for those that maybe, might make other people handle their finances or their shopping, especially when you hit the big time, niggas. Kevin Hart got, they said, for over $1.2 million over the whole duration of the time that he had a personal shopper, some dude named Dylan Sire or something like that. And they said this dude funneled, yo, luxury bags, jewelry, just all type of things, man, watches, and up to $1.2 million, nearly $1.2 million over 2 years. He's now facing second-degree grand larceny charges, and that shows you that Kevin Hart was not watching the books. So let that be a cautionary tale to y'all, man. Do not give anyone control of your finances, because you never know what in the fuck they're out there doing when you know what I'm saying, when they think you're not looking, especially when you're dealing with millions. You're dealing with little bullshit money. You're going to catch that. When you're dealing with multiple millions like that, it's easy to slip through the cracks, so you know how it is. He just got caught slipping. That's all. Also, some good news for Bobby Shmurda. Good news for Bobby Shmurda, man. His mom's jumped on social media and let everybody know that he should be home probably this month. As you know, Rowdy Rebel got released earlier. You know what I mean? So hopefully, once he get out, he links up with the team and they keep their noses clean. And they go about making this bread. They go about making this bread. Get out them streets and make this bread. That's what they should be focused on, in the Batman's opinion. Once again, if it's your first time watching the show, you tune to the Bruce Wayne Live. I'm here every Sunday at 8 p.m. talking my shit. I'm usually able to do the watch party, gather a whole bunch of people to check in at this at the same time. But for some reason, Facebook is fucking with the kid because you know they want them advertising dollars. And Zuckerberg, I'm calling you out, baby. Why can't the Batman use the watch party feature, niggas? What is going on, Facebook? Hey, yo, but it's all good, man. Shouts out to my people that's also watching this on YouTube, Instagram, whatever else you may be seeing this. But, yo, let's jump into some more of that, the interview of Rampage. A little more, man. Let's talk about his banger, man, and Flipmo Squad. We spoke about Wild for the Night and also a little bit about what's going on with the Flipmo Squad.
Yeah. But, you know, Wild for the Night, them thoughts come from producer Backspin, who produced the beat.
Influenced it. Okay.
Me doing the record. So, Backspin, you know, which is one of my producers, gave me a beat. And the next year, you know, I went to the tunnel and I was listening to Funkmaster Flex, everybody playing everybody record. So, I would listen to Wu-Tang and I would listen to all the killers in the $100 billers. And I seen Flex play them records so much, I went home and I made Wild for the Night by listening to both of them records.
Yeah.
And that's what inspired me to do Wild for the Night. And yeah. it was a success and a gold record, you know?
Yeah, it was definitely a success. What's going on with the Flipmo Squad brand? Is that something that's still intact? Is that still a unit?
Let me tell you something. We just finished the new album, bro.
Yeah, man.
That's coming soon. New Flip Mode album.
Okay, that's what's up.
Coming soon.
Okay.
Glad new Flip Mode album coming soon. Busta album just dropped. New Flip Mode album coming soon. And all we solo projects is coming. And my album, When Hell Freezes Over, part one and part two.
Yeah, definitely keep me in the loop with that, man. Definitely keep
Flip Mode conglomerate. You already know.
Keep me in the loop with that. As far as the producers, man. As far as who's your favorite producers to work with? Current,
my favorite,
past,
my
or
favorite,
you know, people still in your circle?
Well, one of my dudes is Felony Music. Next one of my dudes is Black Waters. Next one of my dudes is Drugs Beats.
Mm.
Next one of my dudes, my dude One Technique. Mm. Next one of my dudes, DJ Playwright. These are like dudes in my circle. Fella's my cousin, but he got masses of beats. You'll hear my new album When Hell Freezes Over.
Rampage, man, talking about his hit, his banger Wild for Night and the Flipmo Squad. We're gonna get some more of that interview. Definitely gonna get some more of that interview. Also, man, he got a dope video too, man. I'm trying to make sure I got time to put that on. As far as some contemporary from him. But let's jump into some more news real quick, man. And we're going to jump into that. Something going on with my man Floyd Mayweather. And Jack Paul. Some dude named Jack Paul. Apparently, he's the brother of Logan Paul, who's the guy he's supposed to be fighting. But there's some friction going on there. Some friction going on. I think homeboy may have came out of pocket on Floyd's daughter. And, Floyd basically went in on him, man. He's had some choice words for him. I think he insulted his daughter, Yaya, something like that. Mayweather called him out for wanting to be black. Says he wants a black trainer. I think he was saying something about legend. Oh, Mayweather's going to train him, but they had to fall out. Mayweather said he wants a black trainer. He wants to wear black jewelry like he's black clothing. Basically everything, but he just doesn't want to be black. Yeah, you already know how that goes, Floyd. You already know, baby. He don't want to deal with the discrimination. He just want the fly gear, the fly jewels, and as Mayweather said, he's trying to jack the black man swag. He's trying to jack the black man swag, but he wants no part of the adversity. Anyway, shouts out to Mayweather. Rooting for you in that fight against his brother, hoping that you put his brother on his ass. Hoping you put Logan Paul on his ass, baby. Also, Method Man weighed in this week on the whole thing going on with the whole Eminem and Snoop Dogg beef. And he basically said he believes it was just Eminem's ego. He said, you know, he believes M just got tight because Snoop said he's not in his top 10. And he said M needs thicker skin. He said Eminem needs some thicker skin, and if he gets some thicker skin, that wouldn't happen. Snoop doesn't have to like him just because you're in the same camp. He doesn't have to. That's what he's saying. I mean, out of courtesy, you figure if he's in the camp, you big him up. You know what I mean? Camp unity and all that. But you know what I'm saying? Method Man is saying, yo, get some thicker skin, M. You're saying get some thicker skin. Also, let's jump into it, man. I'm trying to get this full interview in because it was a dope interview. I want to save it for next show. So we definitely going to keep this moving. Some of my man Rampage talking about the Flavor in Your Ear remix, which I was always been curious about as far as how that came about and that chemistry and everything. Check it out. So, as far as the Flavor in Your Ear remix, man, let's talk about that. How did that manifest? That's one of the most popular joints, you know what I'm saying? That's a staple. Well,
every record that I'm on, I'ma just let you know every record that you call, I went gold and platinum. So I'm at the right place at the right time as a young rookie. You know what I'm saying? Fresh off of Beware the Ramsack, but get a call. Buster called me with Craig Mack on the phone. They want me to jump on the Flavor in the Air remix. But get to the studio, me see Puffy, me hear Biggie verse, me see LL in the corner, me see Busta in the corner writing up in verse. We sit there for like 15 minutes. Puffy says to me, yo, how long is it going to take you to do your verse? It took 15 minutes, you know, rude boy. I go in the booth, my lid.
But let me ask you this. So when you came, it was already established you was going to be on the song, or it was just like, yo,
yeah, when I came,
you here, give me something.
Yeah, when I came, it was already established.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah, man definitely had a space for me to be on the record, you know, boy. I was definitely the rookie. That's why I went third. But sure, yeah. My team, you know.
No, but that was still good placement. And you lay down some fire bars, man.
You know what I mean?
That was still some good placement. And
thank you.
Was there a personal relationship though with either Biggie or Mac or
yeah,
L or
them
anybody?
Niggas, well, I used to go out on the road with them. Both of them together. Niggas was my homeboys. Me and Biggie was extra close. Shout out my dude Klepto. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because he lived around the corner from me. Me and Biggie was extra tight. You know what I'm saying? I could tell stories that, you know, hey, I got to tell you off the screen. You know what I'm saying?
Tell me what's on the screen.
Nah, man. I'm just going to let you know, Biggie was a good dude. Biggie, you know, being in the studio with Biggie, watching him going in and doing them bars without writing it down was incredible. Without touching no paper, there was no Pro Tools. So
yeah, I know.
It was off the top, watching him do that. Somebody gave him a pen and pad. He was like, I don't need that.
Yeah.
Yo, roll, yo, seeds roll. Roll 20 minutes after that.
Yeah, you got
very
some.
Very inspiring.
You got some people that's specially gifted like that. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. They just say it, they go in, they lay each bar time for time or whatever. But any Biggie or Mac things floating out there that never was released that you're on? Any music ever done that wasn't?
Yeah, I got a record on my album with Craig Mack, one of the last records he did. It's called You Won't Be Around Next Year.
Yeah, shouts out to Craig Mack, man. Shouts out to
R.I.P. Craig Mack.
R.I.P. to him. That was from I heard his first joint. I was like, yo, this dude is something. And then he disappeared, and then he came back. You know what I mean? Shouts out to him and the legacy he laid. You know what I'm saying? So as far as Craig, did you any on the road things with him or Big?
Yeah, I was on the road with both of them, traveling with them. Yo, it was fun, man. I mean, it was just straight fun. It's them three. I used to open up for both of them.
Okay.
So they let me open up for them. So, you know, we went around the world about a billion times.
Yeah, that's what's up, man.
That's a lot of ass, bras, titties. Hey. What can I
say? I got somebody that watch these things, so you can say all you want. I'm muzzled.
Well, you know what I'm saying? It was just a whole lot of fun, man. When you got powerful records, man, it's just a whole lot of fun, man. You know?
Yeah.
When you got top-topping records, everything goes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I already know.
It's a lot of late nights. A lot of good late nights. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I feel you. You know what I mean? I do what I do, but like I said, I can't indulge that conversation right now.
Okay, I got you.
You know what I'm saying? Had me in the fucking doghouse. But yo. Just kicking it. Talking about the Flavor Year remix and other topics. The Rampage of the Flipmo Squad. Dope interview with that guy. Definitely a dope interview with that guy. Trying to make sure I get all that on here tonight. Because you know I work within my time constraints. But also, man, some more news, man. Just to show you how some people going to make sure they get that bag. Bougie Badass. Bang. Bougie Badass came out this week and said that, you know, for those of y'all that follow hip-hop news and been following the show, that he was shot. He was recently shot in his legs. And despite being shot in his legs, that man went and got the bag, niggas. He went and got the bag. Went and did the show in the wheelchair. That shows you how much he wants to get the bag. Yo, he said he was in so much pain that he cried. He said he was in so much pain that he cried. But he said he had to go get that bag. He said, I think he said it was like 100K on the table, something like that. 50, 100K, something like that. But he said he cried like a baby's first two shows or whatever. And yo, all I can say is, yo, salute that man for going to get that bag. For that 100K, I'll be there too, niggas. I'll be there needing all type of, my tonsils out, appendicitis, you know what I mean? Fresh gunshot wound to the shoulder. I'm going to be right on stage talking about throw your hands in the air and checking the promoter later, like, give me my money, niggas. But yo, shouts out to Boozy Badass, man. Just letting y'all know how hard some of these artists out here grinding. Also, some news with Meek Mill and Tekashi 6ix9ine, but I'm going to get into that after I get into some more of this interview, because like I said, man, dope interview with Rampage, and I want to make sure I get that out here. And this one, he talks about Busta Rhymes, talking about his relationship with Busta, and, you know, a little bit about the pandemic. Let's go. But yo, it's all good, though. So the current relationship with Busta must be great since I got the album. You know what I mean?
Of course, man. Bro, it's flip mode forever. Just because you don't see me always on the forefront, sometimes you ain't got to be always in the front.
Yeah, that's very, you know what I'm saying?
So I'm going to just tell everybody, don't get it fucked up. Flip mode is still a squad. Don't believe what you hearing. Whatever you hearing is a rumor. Kill that noise. New album coming. Ramp coming. Digger coming. Lloyd coming. Sham coming. Spliff coming. Fix your face, man. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I haven't heard anything.
I'm just saying, just in case anybody watched this and getting it fucked up. Don't get it fucked up, because it's never what you think it is.
Nah.
And big up to Busta Rhymes, Extension Level of Event 2, on the album in the country. Also, I'm on that album too.
Yeah, I've definitely been supporting that. I've been playing the videos crazy, bigging them up on the show. Definitely support us. You know what I mean? Anything you got coming down the pipeline too, solo-wise, you know what I mean?
Definitely.
Any visuals or whatever.
Yeah.
How you holding up with this whole pandemic thing, man? How's it affecting the grind, man?
I'm getting into the movement. I'm the president of a new label. I'm getting to the movement. It ain't stopping my grind.
That's what's up.
Not at all.
That's what's up. That's good to hear.
Big up to Moore's Media Entertainment. Yep.
That's definitely good to hear. People out there doing other, you know, other ventures such as yourself. Basically finding other revenue streams, man. You know what I mean?
Well, you know, at the end of the day, it's not what you do, it's what you do with your money. You know what I'm saying? How you do with your money. Me, I'm just changing over. I'm just changing over to a new feel. New album, got a cartoon coming. I got the boom you with. I got the presidency. Ain't nothing gonna stop me. No disease, no COVID, no COVID-21, no COVID-38, none of that.
The new 100 times more infectious shit they pumping out the lab. But yo,
yeah, man.
The cartoon.
Not I.
The cartoon. What's the whole premise of that? What's going on with that?
I'm just working. I've been working on my cartoon for quite some time, but I'm gonna send you a snippet to so you can see it though. But big up to my dude Tommy Ruffin.
Okay, so
my animator.
All right, so it's not where, like, you're not one of the characters or nothing. Like,
yeah, I'm one of the characters.
That's what I'm asking. Like, what's the, you know?
Yeah, but I want to send it to you so you can see it tonight, Rude Boy. I'm going to give you two snippets of it.
Send that over, man. I see you do that. As far as, we're going to come back, man. We're going to come back with some more of the interview, dope interview I got going on with. with Rampage. But yeah, man, as far as that Bougie story too, I was talking about, as far as him going out there and performing in the wheelchair, he says that he don't need the money. He said he has the money. He said he calls it donkey money. He says he gets an adrenaline rush out of performing or something like that. Listen, man, you don't got to save face with me. I'm going to go get that bread, baby. Donkey money or regular money or whatever money. I'm coming for that bag. Also, this is late breaking. Meek Mill and Tekashi 6ix9ine got into it. The video's floating around out there in the club. I think they may have been in Atlanta or something, man. I could be wrong, but I know they got into it. These two got a little ongoing dispute that's been happening for some time. And Meek is saying he tried to set him up. That's what Meek is saying. Meek is saying he said that they were minding their business and he just basically came out of nowhere. Look at Meek's face. Meek's face is like, what the fuck is going on? Because, you know, 6ix9ine was like a rabid Wolverine. He had security with him, so you know it emboldened him. And Meek said, allegedly they're saying that Meek spat on him. I don't know if he did, but that's what they're saying. And a lot of people saying 6ix9ine is looking for attention because he has an album coming out. So they're saying a lot of people believe that's what the case is with that. He's looking for attention because, as we all know, after he got, basically ostracized from hip-hop for being a snitch, his album sales have been in the tank, and he's been with 24-hour security because he believes his life is in danger. So that's what's going on with that. Yo, like I said, man, this your boy Bruce Wayne. I'm here every Sunday talking my shit. Make sure you shoot over to the most popping group on Facebook, Hip Hop Heads Worldwide. If you're not a member, make sure you shoot over there and join the group. Make sure you submit your music, and if it's dope, it'll be approved. If it's not, keep on trying. If you're just a lover of hip hop music and hip hop culture, also make sure you join the group. Once you see that logo, you know you are there. Once you see that Hip Hop Heads logo, you know you are there, baby. That's it. The most popular group on Facebook. Make sure you go over there and join the group. Also, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel. Like, share, and comment on the YouTube channel. I'd appreciate the likes and comments and shares right here on Facebook as well. The YouTube channel is Wayne ENT, baby. Also, you know what I'm saying? Shouts out to our sponsor, which is Bose, and also the Hip Hop Heads Worldwide Apparel. You see, I got the Fly Hip Hop Heads Worldwide Apparel shirt on right here. This is the Black Diamonds joint, man. Make sure you shoot over to Amazon to pick that up. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you shoot over to Amazon to pick that up. Ship through Amazon. And it's dope. It's definitely dope. I want to get back into this real quick, man. Before I throw a video on, I got a video with Rampage and Ryder Ruggin, man. But before that, I want to jump back into this interview because it's a dope interview, and I want to make sure I get it all on during this episode. Just right here, man. I'm just giving Rampage, just giving a little advice to your artists and let y'all know about his DJ Coalition. Let's go. As far as any advice for new artists coming into this, man, you've been through the mill or you've learned, and you say, listen, I'm going to tell you this. Take this jewel.
I'm going to tell you this. Learn to read what you want to get into. Just don't sign any contract, and every contract, it ain't always good for you. Everybody is always not a manager. So stop doing homeboy operation. You want to be in the music business, get a music entertainment attorney, not the homeboy operation. And everybody can't be in the music business. It don't matter how much money you got. You got to be chosen. You got to be chosen. It got to be really in your heart. If it ain't really in your heart, get out the game. Stop stinking up the game. No mumble rap.
Oh, yeah. Let's not start that. Don't open that up. Put that up. I'm not with the mumble rap shit, man. I see you do the DJ thing, too.
Syndicated.
You got a whole militia, a whole coalition going on. What's up with that?
So my coalition is called the Heat DJs. It's about 10,000 of us.
Serious.
10,000 DJs. I do my call every third Wednesday of the month. Every third Wednesday, I do my call. I got every record label. I got every business person, industry head, classical, old, new. You got to jump on my call. You got to jump in the matrix. You know what I'm saying? All my calls between 1,500 and 2,100 people on a call listening. And I'm breaking artists and I'm servicing records. Listening.
That's what's up, man. You've made yourself. That's a great example.
I think I'm syndicated on 61 stations. My shit is called Mix Show Madness.
You see, that's that. I love when I hear people do that, especially people of color. You know what I mean? When we start taking control of this whole thing. You know what I mean? Start taking control of this whole industry thing as far as breaking records wise or media wise or anything with platforms where, you know what I mean? We cuff that culture because it's our culture. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I mean? Anybody else could come to it, but I'm just saying, I like when we set up hubs where we're self-sufficient. You know what I'm saying? And that's definitely what you've done and what you're doing. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, brother.
So that's a salute you. Yo, man, salute to you, man.
I'm glad I'm on Gotham's finest, you know what I'm saying?
I do what I do, man.
And, you know, I just became a president of a new company. So, you know what I'm saying? I got a new, I want everybody to check out my new social media site. It's called Boom You It. It's like the Black YouTube. I own it. It's crazy. I want everybody to get an account. You get an account right now, I'll give you a blue check mark on there. Started it for people that's home that needs to make money. Join the site. You can make money from it. It's not what you do. It's how you do it. You know what I'm saying? So all you got to do is drag, send pictures, send your link. You know, we'll monetize you. You'll make money immediately. The more people you bring to your Boom You It, the more money you.
Yeah, yeah. Make sure y'all shoot over to Boom You It. Go support my man. Sign up for that. I went over there and checked it out. Dope. Definitely dope. A lot of content over there. Definitely a lot of content over there. You know what I'm saying? As I was saying, man, make sure you go get that Hip Hop Heads Worldwide apparel available right now on Amazon. You see the Black Diamond shirt that I'm wearing, as well as the Hip Hop Heads Worldwide Black Diamond hoodie. Also the This That New Dope hoodie and This That New Dope shirt. You can catch me wearing that This That New Dope shirt in the Everywhere video that I'm in featuring my peoples, Percy P, Big D, the whole team and all that. You could definitely go check that out as well. You got the multi-parallel tri-color one as well. So you can go over there and support the kid. Pick up the fly threads. Inbox me a picture with you wearing it, and I'll definitely get it up on the show. Also, man, some tragic news, man, in hip-hop tonight. Just found out about it today. It was early yesterday. About Nicki Minaj, man. Our condolences to her, as we had some tragic news come through the over the line, that her father was killed by a hit and run driver, man. So you know, our condolences to her, Nicki. You know what I mean? Condolences from Bruce Wayne, Wayne Enterprises, my whole team, and my whole fam over here, and the entire Hip Hop Heads Worldwide movement and Facebook group and everybody that's involved in that. Right there you see a picture of her dad, and you know, a woman will always consider herself daddy's little girl, so I know she's going through it right now. So like I said, heartfelt condolences out to Nicki Minaj right now, and just hoping you get through that, sis. Just hoping you get through that, you know what I'm saying? Definitely just hoping you get through that, and you know, hopefully better days and better things are in store for you. Also, man, let's keep it going. I want to throw this video on. This is Rampage with Rod Rugged Man. This is Zigzag. Let's go.
Yeah. Rest in peace, Heavy D. Prayers goes out to my brother Eric Sherman. Real hip hop, we in the building. We don't die. Flatbush Stalker, hat flip back just like I'm Jimmy Walker. Right off the 92 Jedi, just caught the red eye. Haters said I said I never said that. Now I'm back to the gaming. Now I keep flaming, calling my name in. Fell, we keep banging. Back to the UK, shout out to the DJs. No more delay, North Philly EA. Hit the turnpike, now I'm back to the BK. Babas on the bridge through the 95 freeway. I'm just grieving on y'all. Lifestyle is crazy, bouncing off the wall. The way I work my game, I'm like 6 feet tall. The way I break it down, I'm like uncut raw. The word in the street, yo, I'm that ball. Break it down, real science. Jolly green giant, steaming like an iron. Roar like a lion. Killing up the game, all the rules I'm applying. This time around, I'm a 4 mile lions. I'm not playing, I'm not joking. In and out your city, yo, your boy stay coasting. 20 for the walkthrough, all your boy is hosting. Let me clear my throat. Boxing so hard, knock you against the rope. Yeah. Yo, zigzag tick. Gotta make moves. Gotta think quick. Gotta move fast. Gotta haul ass. Come around here, yo, you don't get a pass. Yeah. Yo, zigzag tick. Gotta make moves. Gotta think quick. Gotta move fast. Gotta haul ass. Come around here, yo, you don't get a pass. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to bring on my dude.
No, don't do it.
Y'all know him as Mr. Don't Badman. I'm going to give it up to my man, R.A., the Rugged Man.
Boom, Rizzy, boom. I'm a soul man like Sam Dave. The Rugged Man rampage back on the damn stage. My flow high, you can use it to light fires. R.I.P. Heavy Diddly 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 D. Dwight Myers walking in between the Twin Towers on high wires. This for Harlem, boogie down Bronx, Brooklyn to do or die. Flipping tables at restaurants, I don't need no reservation. You more artificial than artificial insemination. I'm the king forever reigning from generation to generation. Remaining from Genesis to the Book of Revelation. I was born pissed off, I stay hating. I walk the streets looking like a monarch with the mad face invasion. I remain the heaviest living, spitting the deadliest venom in them. If it wasn't for rapping, I'd be buried in debt or in prison. I rhyme with a vengeance, my opposition is never forgiven. I wreck them and get them spitting green soup in their head to be spinning. I'm like zigzag zigger, flipping the zag zigzag. I'm the George Thorogood of rap, I'm bad. Ain't impressed by steroid needles and weight training. You 300 pound bouncers get knocked out, I ain't playing. Tales from suburbia, rock the party, the home of rock and prodigy. Bust a bust, De La Pump, Nux and Rock Marcy. And P, Prince Paul, the whole army. And Rugged Man, you don't want no parts of me. Come on.
Yeah. Yo, zigzag tick. Gotta make moves. Gotta think quick. Gotta move fast. Gotta haul ass. Come around here, yo, you don't get a pass. Yeah. Yo, zigzag tick. Gotta make moves. Gotta think quick. Gotta move fast. Gotta haul ass. Come around here, yo, you don't get a pass.
Knuckles, you get massacred. Move or get moved, I come through like Hulk smash. Separate your soul from your body, nigga, do the math. Nerve of these nigga poops, thinker, nigga, box with God. Sever your arms, laugh, feed them to the dogs. Hood nigga, probably sold you weed and fucked your moms. What you mad about? I help to keep the lights on. I don't pop mollies, always time for true religion, jeans, polo top, and a hot broad. Superhuman, how he spits it like a cyborg. My bars bite through your bones like an alligator. Still execute these rappers like the gas chamber. Wearing dresses on stage, man, that shit ain't boss. The Jamaican in me wanna take the ass apart. Bun a split, lick a couple shots, and you're on
my shit is venomous, like a cobra bite.
Yes, we back in the building. Yeah, that was Zigzag Zig with Rod Rugged Man, man, or my man Rampage joint. Then, you know, a little bit of Batman on Venom. Let's jump back into this interview, man. I had a chance to ask my man about legacy, Rampage, on his legacy. And he had some interesting comments. Let's go. Your legacy. When 1,000 years from now, but they dig us up, You know what I mean? And they come across Rampage, man. What you want your legacy to be, man? Anybody, when that come out, that Rampage, the last Boy Scout. You know what I mean? I know you have no plans on retiring. I know you currently active.
Oh, fuck no.
No, you're contemporary.
I'm just saying my legacy, though.
Your legacy, man. What you
want to
be?
I just want my kids to keep moving. You know what I'm saying? My kids to keep eat off my music. You know what I'm saying? License it. Do something okay. with it. It's not for sale.
Yeah.
I just want them to live off of it. Black wealth.
That's what's up.
But I just want to leave something for my children. That's it.
Yeah,
that's it. I got six. I want to just leave a heavy music influence on my kids. They can play it to my grandkids and my great grandkids and my great grandkids, and my great grandkids is gonna be all right. And after that, then that's when it start getting crazy.
Yeah, but that's man. That's what it's all about anyway. But as far as
I want to leave them. I gotta leave them on my royalties. They can't sell it at all. They just gotta license it.
But as far as the fans and as far as hip hop as a whole, your legacy, like you
dope rapper,
you a rugged MC.
First of all, I never want to be in the top 10, because when you put people in the top 10, it get crazy. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's confused. So, dope rapper, Flatbush MC, Brooklyn to the fullest, Flipmo's first lieutenant. You know, the Brooklyn Bomber, me, that's it, man. I'm dope MC. Never had no whack bars, ever.
Mm-hmm. My brother, I concur. You know what I'm saying? I definitely concur with that. Anything else you might want to put out there that I haven't touched on, let me know.
Everybody, if you hating on me, Flipmo Squad, and Gotham City, fix your goddamn face. I'm coming regardless.
But definitely. Yeah, man, you rocking with Gotham's finest, man. You
rock with
Gotham's finest, man. The Batman, Bruce Wayne. I'm glad you came through. What's the social media links? The other thing he's talking about, people want to just connect with you on the social media.
My Instagram at The Real Rampage. My Twitter at The Real Rampage. Instagram, Heat DJ number one. Instagram, Mix Show Madness. Facebook, Roger Rampage McNair, man. I got issues. I got a lot of pages.
I love when I talk to my people, because you know, so we must make it massive. But y'all,
definitely, you must have 21 jobs, you know.
Listen, yeah, you definitely right about that.
Tsar is a title used to designate supreme rulers. It is known as to be equivalent to king. Or to be somewhat in between a royal, an imperial rank. The last person to have borne the title Tsar.
Look, they don't get it. Now watch a nigga set it, you know I'm coming to shred it. With rubies all on my rings like Thanos present. I'm tired of talking to niggas, they get no credit. You get no debit. Watch the way we improve. Keep the way that we move. We need a whole segment.
What's up?
To talk about some you niggas. You need a new helmet. Crash dummy, you niggas. You need a new exit. And whip a private plane, get your head from the flight attendant. I got a mob like the Navy SEALs in the Air Force.
Take change on. Anything on.
Pilot flying the plane, we make them change course. I don't play sports. Whole clean force. Now niggas gon' learn that I brown niggas with the fire. Niggas beg me to chill and gon' make more records with Mariah. They want me give them some more. Take my niggas on tour. Okay. If your niggas unsure, I'ma give you the raw. Watch the way we sweep up shit. Peep the way we clean up shit. Classic album is present. Peep the way we heat up shit. Masterpiece project. Peep the way a nigga beat up shit. If your niggas think you fuckin' with us, better speak up, bitch.
So far, shorty's throat, eh, bro? And I need a lighter than light. The perfect cigar. Brand new jet, brand new car, leader of the new.
Yeah, we back. Shouts out to the kid Rampage once again for coming through. I had thrown a little bit of that Tsar joint. Dope interview with the lieutenant. Dope interview with the lieutenant, the Flipmo Squad. You know, I like to keep these things too long. I like to keep them at least under an hour within my time constraints. But shouts out again for him to coming through. Shouts out to Nicki Minaj. Once again, our condolences to her and the passing of her father. Make sure you go over to Boom You With and check my man Rampage out. That social media joint he got going on is dope. Until next time, Stay safe and COVID free. I'm out of here, family. I'm out of here.